is my second attempt of filming this like drunk get ready with me. The first time I filmed it with my best friend Ellie, it didn't really work out just because our boyfriends were in the background talking, and as much as I tried to edit it, you just could hear them. So, and sadly she couldn't make it tonight, so here I am. All you got is me, but deal with it. Okay, so tonight I'm gonna be drinking Tito's. The first time I attempted to do this, I actually forgot alcohol, but this time I have alcohol. Fresh bottle of Tito's coming at you. It's cold. So I figure I'll just take like two shots. Jesus. I'll just take two shots back to back, and then I'll wait like 10 minutes or so for them to kick in, and then I'll come back and I'll do my makeup. And I'm gonna answer some questions while I do it, but this time I think I'm gonna try to like, last time I just did my makeup and I had fun with it, but this time I think I'm gonna like try to do it in under 15 minutes, like my full face. So we'll see what comes of all that. But in the meantime, I have my Sprite, my two shots of vodka. Let's see how this goes. I don't like drinking at all, so the faces that come after this, I apologize. One down. Shot number two. Okay, two shots later, I feel nothing. Duh, I just took them. Okay, two shots later, we'll see what happens in the next like 15 minutes, 10 minutes, I don't know. I'm gonna just sit and chill, listen to music, get my vibe. We'll see how long it takes for me to start getting a little tipsy, and I'll be back to do my makeup and be a wreck. Okay, so I've already taken two shots. I'm a lightweight, so I'm pretty tipsy. It took like maybe 10 minutes for that to kick in like fully. So I'm gonna start doing my makeup. This is gonna be a train wreck. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna start priming my face. And just so you guys know, I won't be like putting on falsies or anything, and I probably already look like I'm semi-done because I just got my lash extensions done like yesterday. So yeah, there's that. So that'll also be easier, I guess, for like the 15 minute challenge, but whatever. It's 8:45 p.m. so we'll set one for 9 and see where that takes us. Quiet on set. So that's for 9 p.m. so 15 minutes starts now. What is the worst part of living in Portland? Okay. The worst part of living in Portland. Traffic, because I'm not used to like a lot of traffic from where I came from. And then probably, I hate to say it, but like all the homeless, not just because like they don't bother me, but it's just sad. Like you would come across like a few every now and then where I was born and raised, which was in, sorry, I'm gonna turn the music down just in case it's too loud. But you would see like a few homeless people every now and then in Boise, but it's like everywhere here. It's very populated, and it's not like gross or anything. I understand they all have their reasons, but I just feel saddened by it. I wish there was more that like the world, the cities, everybody could do just to like to lessen that, because like I didn't see it so crazy where I was before, and now I see it a lot. So I would say like the really big thing is like my worst part about living in Portland would be traffic and just seeing all the homeless people. Like, it just makes me sad. So I got the question, what is something you've always wanted to do but have been scared to? It's a really good one. There's a lot that I've wanted to do, but I've been like scared to do it. I really want to go skydiving. I talk big game about being like, anybody who wants to go skydiving, let's go. But I'm not sure if like I would really want to jump out of a plane, and like, honest to God, like, I'm just not sure. But that is something that I would like to do. I'm just a little too scared. And honestly, like, I've been talking to all my friends, all my family about wanting to make the transition into being a doula, but I'm just like scared. I don't know why. It's just something so new to me, and like, I don't really know a whole lot about it, but like, my heart just feels so set in it. So I'm scared, but I don't know. That's, I guess, another thing that I want to do, but I'm a little scared. I don't know why. Time for some concealer. And we'll do another question, because I forgot I'm timing this. I'm a wreck. I love this one so much. My friend asked me, what is the dumbest way you've been injured? Oh, honey, let me tell you. Okay, so let's start from when I was youngest to when I was oldest, the dumbest injuries I've had right now. The youngest to date that I remember, like, dumbest injury I've had, right, was like 11. I was at my friend's birthday party, and we were all having like fun on their bouncy house that they rented, and I was just following suit, okay? If your friend jumps off a bridge, you're gonna jump off a bridge. Apparently, I'm gonna jump off a bridge if my friend jumps off a bridge. Like, ask me if I'm 11, and I'm gonna do it. But when we were all at the birthday party, they were going, so like, imagine this bouncy house that's like a whole like castle thing, and you like have like a slide that you can go down, but the slide is covered like halfway by like a net thing. Whatever, you get it. So they were all crawling to the top on the outside of the bouncy house, sitting on the outside, and then like pencil barrel rolling like down the halfway like cover thing onto the slide and falling perfectly fine. And so like I watched like three of them do it, and I'm like, cool, yeah, so much fun, I'm gonna follow suit of this super dangerous idea. And so yeah, I started pencil rolling, and I'm like going like this. Next thing you know, I'm on the ground. I think I only fell like a foot onto like grass instead, just like my body like angled the wrong way, and I landed on my elbow and I broke it. Have little, I don't know if you can see at all, but there's a scar there. I had to get 4 pins, wear a cast, blah blah blah. I had to write with my left hand. That was a terrible time. And now my elbow hurts all the time, and I just got told that actually a pin could be slipping by a chiropractor the other day. But that was a very dumb injury, because it was like totally self-inflicted. Like, I could have just not rolled off of it like everybody else, but I wanted to be cool, and I just got injured and was crying like a little baby for my mommy, and I had to go to the hospital. So there's that. And then also, my high school, when I was like a junior, we all went to Disneyland. Yeah, long story short, I was on my phone at nighttime looking down. I ran into a tree and got a concussion. Yeah, and I've had multiple concussions before, so like, not my first rodeo, but my parents weren't very happy. Nobody at the school was very happy that I got a concussion on the trip. It wasn't the best time, yeah, but memories. I've had a lot of concussions, but they're not as dumb as, I guess, those last two. Yeah, I just get injured all the time. I'm a klutz, so let's be real. Okay, after concealer, I'm taking another shot. Oh my god. I almost just dropped that whole thing on the ground. Okay. So tuck your chain, I'm a killer girl, I'm sorry. But I can't chain, we ain't aiming for your body. Shots hit your brain. We come from poverty, man, we ain't have a thing. It's a lot of animosity, but they won't say my name. Them killers rock me, the nigga don't get banged. Cause they have a job for me while I hop on the plane. She don't like her body, left the doctor with a new shape. Blowing up my phone cause she just see me with my new babe. Heartbreaker late. Just realized that there's no way in hell I'm gonna get done with this makeup in 15 minutes if I'm actually drinking. I don't know if you caught a word that I said in that because I kind of slurred it, but I don't know if I'm gonna finish this makeup in 15 minutes. So, no timer, I'm just gonna do my makeup and answer questions. Fuck it, right? oh, this is a good one, okay. So as I go into the rest of my makeup, I'm gonna answer some questions. I like how I'm even trying at this point. Like, girl, we all know. Anyways, somebody said fave skincare products and your microblading experience. Okay, I love this. So skincare, not makeup, just skincare. My favorite products. I like stuff by First Aid Beauty skincare, really, really good. I use like their cleanser and like their moisturizer. I love it. And then I also use the Exuviance Bio Oxygen Facial Mask. I want to say that's what it's called. It's like you put it on as a mask and it goes on smooth as a liquid and then it starts to bubble up and it turns into bubbles and then the bubbles start to disappear. And it's just like, it's the weirdest feeling. I love it. It makes my skin look like glass. Like, no lie. That's what I'm saying, the biggest joke. I'm supposed to be done with my makeup right now and I'm baking. Look it up, by Exuviance, Ulta. I love it. So, the Exuviance mask and then First Aid Beauty skincare, I love all of it. And then Kiehl's also has like this nighttime oil. You don't have it on me right now, I just ran out, I don't know the name. But I love it. It's like midnight. It's blue. Kiehl's. I don't remember. I'm so sorry. I'm the worst at this. Oh my god. Okay, you know when a song just touches your soul? Love on the Brain. Rihanna. Rihanna. Whatever you want it to say. I love this song. Got me like a was that Silas?
Yeah.
In the video I sent you?
Yeah.
Oh, baby hairs. No, no. So, I just contoured off of camera. I have no clue what happened. It stopped recording. So, I was contouring and the next thing you know, I wasn't. So, here I am, my sloppy mess of a contour right now. Yeah. Let's get into the next question, I guess. Best difference between Idaho and Portland. Best difference between Idaho and Portland is the fact that it's just more cultured here. Like, there's a lot of different types of people here. It's not such a, like, closed-minded mindset. I hate boxing Idaho, Boise into, like, one specific place, but, like, or one specific group. But, sadly, I do. Like,
I know it's not right, but I just like that it's more open-minded here. And the fucking food carts, dude. Like, food carts central. They're everywhere. I love food. I love food carts. It's my love language. It's my son's love language. Like, all the food carts, please. The best difference between Idaho and Portland. The food carts. Or, like, the trails. I don't know. I feel like a fatty saying that, but it's just the truth. My truth. I'm gonna add a little bit of blush. I look like a clown right now. Okay, I just did my blush. Somebody said, what's the best thing about being a mother? The best thing about being a mother. Ooh, that's a good one. The best thing about being a mother, I feel like, is just like watching them grow, right? Like, I created you in my stomach for 9 months, almost 10, and you're my little, like, spawn of genes mixed with your dad's genes, and, like, I get to watch you grow every day, and, like, he does something new every day. Every day I'm just, like, so amazed and appalled at the things that he can do without me even, like, teaching him sometimes. Like, he is so smart, and, like, I would just say the best thing about being a mother is watching your kid explore the world and learn new things and gain a personality. Like, they go from kind of being like this very fragile little being to like having such a like spunky, fun little toddler terror. I'm just kidding. A fun attitude. And it's just, it's very different seeing their personality when it comes out. And it's just like, it's so fun being a mom because like, it's like, wow, I made that. I'm just so excited to watch somebody pursue their dreams and like care for them. And just the best part about being a mom is being a mom. Okay, for some highlight. I'm a wreck.
Don't do it. Or do it.
My boyfriend doesn't want me to take another shot, but I say, fuck it. I'm just kidding, I probably shouldn't. We'll see. Did you see that?
I don't know.
It fell right in my boobs. I bought a Tracy McQueen. Get that ass shake out. Come here. Peer pressure. I'm just kidding. Are you gonna chug the whole thing like that? No.
No. I'm just gonna take it. But not the whole thing. I'm just gonna
put it in a shot glass. Right. Chug.
It was like a shot.
I told you it was like a double shot. Oh, it's just one shot?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. I'm just kidding.
I know.
Wait, where's your Sprite? You need it?
No.
I have one right here if you need it.
That's water.
That's Sprite, I promise. I have water somewhere else. Right. You're not on camera. Come sit on my lap.
I'm not gonna sit on
Come
your
call
lap.
Me daddy. No. What does baby want for Christmas?
Well, yeah, what
Come
do
here.
You want?
I'm saying it. Chug. You're not on camera, it's okay.
It's okay.
Oh, mama didn't raise no bitch?
Nope.
Are you seriously considering moving back to Idaho? Quentin's shaking his head no. Okay, for all those who don't know, for a while we were talking about maybe going back to Idaho. and like I joke about it a lot, and like I really like a huge part of me wants to, right? Like, because I really, 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 really miss family. Like, friends, not replaceable, but like you can make new friends, right? But family is like forever, and I don't have family out here. Quentin doesn't have family out here. It's hard just on the family aspect. So like sometimes I joke about going back to Boise, but I don't know if I can leave Portland. I absolutely love it here. As much as I do miss Boise, I would just miss Portland more. Like, ugh, I don't know what to do sometimes. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe in a few years, maybe tomorrow. Who knows? We're so, like, back and forth. Get out of here. My cat. We're so back and forth on our decision that I really just, like, the pros, the cons, I don't know. I really don't know. Good question. No real answer. Social anxiety and trying to be a YouTuber don't mix. I don't know what I'm doing. Little purple underneath, because why not? Ooh, girl. I want another shot, but Quentin said if I have another shot, I might throw up, which is very possible for me. But I want another shot. Yeah. What is the most challenging thing you've encountered being a mother, friend, and girlfriend? Fuck. Balancing it all. I hate saying like the word needy, because it's not that everybody's needy. It's just that everybody has needs, and it's hard like meeting everybody's needs, right? Like Silas has his own needs. My boyfriend Quentin has his own needs. My family, like they all have their own needs, and it's hard tending to every relationship with like care sometimes, because it's just like me personally, I'm such a stubborn, hard-headed person, so sometimes in friendships, relationships, I tend to like throw in the towel where I'm just like, oh my god, screw it, right? Like I don't have the effort to put in anymore, because it's like it's so overwhelming trying to balance it all. Like kudos to people who can balance it all perfectly and like they don't have a flaw, because me, like I don't balance it well, honestly. Like it can be a lot at times. I shut down at times. I can close people out. I'm talking with my hands. But like it's just the truth. It's just the truth though. Like I'm not the best at balancing it. It's hard. Like right, being a sister and a daughter and a girlfriend was one thing, and like a friend was one thing, right? I had a lot more time. I have a baby on my hands now. I don't have a lot of time. My main focus is Silas, and then my relationship with Quentin, just because like those are the two main people that I see on a daily basis and that I need to make my life work with. And for the other parts, it's like it's hard for me sometimes. And it shouldn't be, but it is. And like, I find myself in kind of like that dilemma a lot, because I am stubborn and it's hard. What was the question? Oh. That was a question I forgot to answer with the skincare products. How was my microblading experience? Perfect. My eyebrows healed amazing. Alex, Alexandra, Blooming Beauty, all these names. She's amazing. Like she as a person is a beautiful soul. Her work, she's super talented. My brows healed really, really well. I wouldn't even complain. She does my lashes. Like they went through the normal stages of like microblading. It's not even actually what I got. I got an ombre powder brow like tattoo. They faded for a little bit. They were dark in the beginning for the first 2 days. They faded for like a little bit, maybe like a couple days. They flaked a little bit, the pigment was gone, came back, and they healed perfectly. I recommend her to anybody in the Vancouver, Portland, traveling area. I don't care. Come to her. Like, she is amazing. Yeah. Enough said. If you laugh at me one more time, I'm gonna kill you. I feel like I look like a clown. Okay, whatever. That's my eyebrows. Sorry, Alexandra. Don't kill me. I need another shot. I'm gonna take another shot. Shot, shot, shot.
I need to get pumped for this
shot. Yes! Wait, I'm gonna call my friend. Let's see if she'll pump me up for my last shot. Before I get cut off, yeah.
Hi, baby.
Hi, what are you doing? She answered. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna take a shot and I need you to pump me up, okay?
Okay.
It's my last shot for the night because Quentin's cutting me off because apparently I'm already too drunk, so. Cutting me off.
Tell Quentin to fuck off.
Fuck off, Quentin. Okay, cheers.
Get it, girl.
Love you. I'll talk to you in a little bit.
Okay.
Okay. Bye. That was my best friend, Sedona, my little sister, scissor sister for life. I love her. Okay, four shots down, probably like the last shot of the night because it's my last shot of the night. I just got the final nod in the background. I'm not mad at it. I'm pretty tipsy. I said I was gonna be tipsy after two shots. My makeup doesn't look terrible. Ooh. I don't know what this song is. What is this? Ooh. Your teeth in my neck. Okay, bye. Can you? I don't think you can. No, okay, whatever. Let's see. Oh, girl. Fuck. That's blurry. That's almost too good of quality for my face right now. Yeah, this is the finished look. Four shots of vodka later, which isn't a lot to the average person, I guess, but it's a lot to me. I'm a lightweight. I have IBS. I'll make all these excuses. I don't know. I'm a bitch. Four shots is a lot for me, so enjoy this shit show, whatever this was. This was the look. I don't even know what I'm doing right now. Yeah, try to be serious. I don't even think I can. I'm a wreck. I don't know what this was for. Just for fun. I tried to like match my pink and be like all cute and stuff and my purple. I don't even know if this makes sense. Thank you for watching. Though my ego, let me know how you like this look or if I'm just an idiot for even attempting to do this. I don't know why I'm touching my hair. I actually just used Monat, I don't know what it's called actually for the first time. Shout out to my girl Leah. Go follow her. I think her at just actually Leah Avalos. Avalos Leah. I don't know. I'm so sorry. I'll look it up and tag it down in the description below. But I love the way my hair looks so far just after two washes. And I can't wait to see the rest. Not even an ad. It just actually looks good. I'm drunk. I wish I could drink the rest of this bottle. But like I said, I'm a bitch. So I can't. But I hope you like this video. I don't know what this was for. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. Let's have a little talk. Oh, God. We're drunk. Katie, chat with my boyfriend time. How do you think I am as a YouTuber? Scale 1 to 10.
10 at least.
Don't lie just because we have sex. I'm just kidding. Don't lie just because you're my boyfriend.
No. 7.
I feel it. Maybe like a 4. I don't know why I have viewers, but I appreciate all of you.
11.
He took a double shot of tequila. How do you feel?
Fine. The same. High as I was.
He's a liar. He's drunk. My gosh. My makeup looks pretty good for being drunk. Okay, the real question. How do you rate my makeup for being pretty drunk for myself?
11.
Really? Wow, that was so wholesome of him. He's really pretty mean to me for some reason. Okay, well, oh. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, bye. He dipped. But thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. Watch next time. Who knows what it's going to be? Maybe it'll be me getting drunk. Maybe it'll be me changing diapers. Maybe it'll be me going on a family trip. I don't know. Watch. Can I have another shot?